Welcome to another session of Optical Communication Networks, Unit 4, Access Networks. Next topic we are discussing now is Optical Time Division Multiplexing. Optical Time Division Multiplexing. Here the Time Division Multiplexing. Now first of all discuss about what is meant by Time Division Multiplexing. Why we are going for Time Division Multiplexing? First of all, we are discussing about access network. Access networks. Here, what is meant by access network? And what is meant by multiple access networks? The access network is a thing, but we have to take service. We have to take the service from the local exchange, from the server, or from the service provider, whichever it may be. Multiple access service is a thing, but a single path is there. Multiple users are utilize the same path. Multiple users are utilize the same path. That is called the multiple access. Here, how many types of basic multiple access techniques? Frequency division multiplexing, time division multiplexing, code division multiplexing. Here, what is meant by frequency division multiplexing? A single path is there for each customer having own frequency, having own carrier frequency to utilize the particular path. Nothing but n number of users is there, nothing but n number of carrier frequencies you required to transmit. But we are going for time division multiplexing. Here in this time division multiplexing, suppose n number of customers are there, are utilizing the same single path at a time by using single carrier for all n users with different time slots. For time slot one utilized by customer one, time slot two utilized by customer two, and time slot n utilized by customer n with the same carrier frequency. That is about time division multiplexing. The next one is code division multiplexing. Here in this code division multiplexing, instead of frequency, instead of time slots, based upon the randomly generated pseudo nice code, we have to transmit the data or signal from many number of users to you to through a single path. Here, the topic is optical time division multiplexing. Optical time division multiplexing, nothing but the number of multiple light signals or optical signal are multiplexed together by using a time division concept. Right, suppose I'm taking one village. In that particular village having a 50 landline connections. A 50 landline connection in the particular village having one local exchange is there, telephone exchange. All 50 locations are connected to one local exchange via parallel connection. Parallel connection, but all 50 different path lines are coming together and going to one local exchange. From your landline connection to nearer to local exchange, having maximum of supports in terms of kbps supports, but from one local exchange to another local location connection you have to take place. That is basing the concept of trunk line. Here the trunk line suppose instead of mbps and gbps at a time 50 users are call can be take place, but it supports the trunk line. That is the trunk line having high capacity than the individual line. Here, based upon this concept, we are going for optical time division multiplexing. Here, nothing but here in this optical time division multiplexing, here what is meant by multiplexing and what is meant by demultiplexing. Here at the time of multiplexing, a lower speed of data streams, lower speed of data streams are multiplexed together and given to high speed data streams. Number of lower speed data streams are connected to one point and sent through a high speed streams. Here at the demultiplexing section, from high speed is converted into low speed streams. That is, we have to extract the lower speed streams from the high speed streams. Here, this optical time division multiplexing is identical to electronic time division multiplexing. And what is the difference? In general, electronic time division multiplexing working the principle of electrical signals we have to transmit. But in optical, we have to convert from optical to electrical to optical, then transmits. That is the main difference. Here, the optical time division multiplexing supports 100 Gbps sub speed. Here, see this there. See this one time division multiplexing having two types here: bit interleaved and packet interleaved. Bit interleaved and packet interleaved. Next, what is the difference between here? How many number of input streams say here? There, bit interleaved. See this one, bit interleaved time division multiplexing. Here, the number of users are 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 4 users. For each user transmits 3 bits. For each user transmits 3 bits. All bits are multiplexed together, then go for output. Right. Here, all the bits are multiplexed, then transmits through high speed data stream. Here we are check framing pulses. Here, what is the use of framing pulses here? Here, the framing pulses are used from what is the exact starting of the data, and we have to check whether it is going for exact location path or not, based upon the source and destination address. Here, how many users are, we have to assume that in this bit interleaved, 4 users, and each user has 3 bits. Nothing but where exactly these framing pulses are inserted, where is the framing pulses are inserted in the bit multiplexed stream. Nothing but it depends upon number of customers. Here, nothing but here, first you have to transmit. First you have to transmit first framing pulse, then transmit 1, 0, 0, 0. Then again, frame pulse can be added. Nothing but number of customers depends upon the number of customers is 4. Nothing but every 4 bits transmitted, we have to insert one framing pulse. Every 4 bits transmitted, we have to insert one framing pulse in a network. It is about bit multiplexed stream. Next, the second type is packet interleaved TDM, time division multiplexing. Here also we have to assume that 4 customers are there, for each customer having 3 bits. But the output of this packet interleaved TDM, nothing but here the framing pulses are inserted. The framing pulses are inserted. Every packet should be transmitted. Nothing but 1, 0, 0 transmit successfully. Then insert one framing pulse for next 0, 1, 1. Next again frame pulse are added. Next 1, 0, 1. Next again framing pulse are added. Next 1, 1, 1. This is about the function of packet interleaved optical multiplexing. This is the difference between bit interleaved TDM and packet interleaved TDM. Here in this bit interleaved case, if n inputs data streams are to be multiplexed, a framing pulse is used for every n bits. But in packet interleaved case, framing pulses are mark the boundary between the packets. Here, suppose we have to assume that n data streams are to be multiplexed. Nothing but n customer data are multiplexed together. And what is the bit period? For each bit period is, we have to assume that capital T. Suppose the pulses are delays. The pulses are delay, some delay. The delay is tau. That is called the interpulse width. Is nothing but tau equal to T by n plus 1. Nothing but, what do you mean n plus 1? Which shows transmitted in the each bit period. Next. But assume that the temporal width is tau p is less than or equal to tau, must should be satisfied. Here, see this one, bit interleaving concept. Bit interleaving. Now we are assuming that bit, how the exactly the bit interleaving works. Bit interleaving works based upon the time division multiplexing. Right. The first we have to take here. Mode lock laser, nothing but the laser light should be on for every bit. Now we are not sending any data, just every bit period, the light pulse should be on. See this one, this is a time period, this is the light should be on. Next, which is going to splitter concept. Why you are going for splitting here? Here, splitting is a thing, but suppose n number of users are there. For all n number of users required the light signal to transmit. That's why we have splitting. Here, the number of customers are from 1 to n minus 1. Suppose for this splitting, we are going for delayed pulses. Why you are delaying? For first customer, the laser output transmitted successfully. For second person, somewhat delay. That's why it is a delayed pulses. Next, we are going for modulation. Here, this modulation, the input is laser signal, and then the carrier. We are taking another one is message signal data, that is 101101. Then modulation takes place. After modulation, see this one. The one is the light is on. Zero, there is no light on. One is light on. Likewise, the output of the modulator pulses. Now we are inserted framing pulses by using the concept of combiner and or star coupler. We are using star coupler, that is many number of customers send their data to a star coupler. We are getting output. Here we have to insert a framing pulse for the output of the modulator. Here in this bit interleaving concept, where exactly have to insert framing pulses? The framing pulses are used to insert, it depends upon the number of customers, n number of customers. This is about bit interleaving time division multiplexing. Here, this is about bit interleaving optical demultiplexer. Once the signal is transmitted through optical fiber cable, we have to receive the multiplexed input. Here we have to go for splitting. This is the received data with the frame pulses. We had to go for split first one. That is, by removing this framing pulses and split the data based upon the number of customers to be transmitted. And directly we have to receive the output of the splitter or star coupler to AND gate first. Another name is delayed. We have to delay some this received data. Receive data and go for threshold. Here, what is used of threshold? At the time of receiving the data, we are getting some problems. That is, pulse shape should be changed, and some errors are occurred. That's why I go for threshold. Above threshold, it should be 1. Below the threshold, it should be 0. Then output of threshold also give to AND gate. Here, AND gate nothing but ending the splitting output at threshold output, the final it shows original data which should be transmitted. This is about time division demultiplexing by using bit interleaving concept. Now we are going for packet interleaving. How the packet interleaving works exactly. Here this is packet interleaving. Here also we are taking input is mode lock laser Here in this mode lock laser, every bit period is capital T. Continuously the light should be on. Next, go for directly go for modulator. Here in this modulator, we are taking the laser output is as a carrier signal, and data we have to take is the message signal. The data should be 101101. Then we have to go for compression stage. First compression, second compression, third compression. Here number of compression stages are required. Here why you are going for compression stage? Here see this one. First one bit, the laser is on. Zero. There is no light signal. One, light is present. One, light is present. Zero, no light is present. One, light is present. After first compression stage, the first pulse move to second bit period. The third pulse move to fourth bit period. Likewise, the number of compression stages required. Finally, we are getting, we have to transmit which pulses are on. Then only transmit the particular path. No need for remaining. Automatically, the bandwidth wasting is we have to minimize in this packet interleaving stage. Here nothing but how many number of compression stages in the particular block. Nothing but suppose that the length of the packet contains L bits. So we are taking one packet. How much length of the particular packet is L bits? Then number of compression stages K equal to log L base 2 compression stage. Log L base 2 compression stage. Okay, see this one. Suppose I have assumed that J compression stage is there. Nothing but a 3 dB coupler. The input pulses we are giving. Here we are using two semiconductor based optical amplifier for on and off condition switches, on and off condition switches and delay. We are getting for delay. We are using two, already you know the concept how the semiconductor amplifier works by using the concept of pump. What is the pump? Here laser is acts as a pump. And one SOA is for delay, another SOA without delay. The final we are getting in 3 dB coupler, we are getting output is pulses with some delay. After jth compression deadline, how much it is compressed? It is 2 power j minus 1 capital T minus tau. What is my tau here? How much delay? This is how compression can be takes place. Why are we going for compression? We have to reduce large size of data to small size. At the interleaving stage, at demultiplying stage, uncompressing. So see this one here in this packet interleaving. Instead of transmitting total length, some bits are zero. We are wasting up the light on and off condition. And size also high. We have to remove the size. We have to go for compress the virtual data. For demultiplexing operation, just like in reverse condition, you will go for number of decompressed stages. And based upon the pulse is present, it should be one. Pulse is absent, this should be zero. This is about demultiplexing operation. Do you have any query? Type your query in a chat box. Thank you very much for attending this session.